Okay, before we can even start episode 2, let me tell you guys the story of everything that went wrong with episode 1. Okay, first of all, this is a new game. I had to start the game over. You can see I haven't died yet in this file. I have everything else I've done. And those 29 minutes that it took me for the first episode, this time it took me 8. Like I said, short game, and if you skip the cutscenes, you know what you're doing. Yeah, 8 minutes. That's no big deal. So, okay, first of all, episode 1 took me several attempts to record it. My first time trying to record this game, I just turn on the game system, get everything set up. I just hit the record button, start game, you know, usual stuff, normal. And then I played in one sitting all the way from the beginning to the end of the Ginso tree and stopped there, recorded like 3 different recording sessions, but all at once. Played back all of them and found out that the first file was corrupted and I couldn't use it at all. So, okay, scrap all that, throw all of it away, try again. Go back to the home menu. In the home menu, set everything up, hit record, start game, record again. Same deal, 3 recording sessions through all the way through the end of the Ginso tree. Once again, just the first video file was corrupted. So, at that point, I had a theory that perhaps for some bizarre reason my Roxio capture card does not like the Xbox dashboard, and it made sense to me because I remember when I streamed PS4 games with Cole, every single time you went to the home menu or did anything that wasn't the game itself, it blocked it out of the stream, and you would be hearing just our commentary only. It would not show anything that is not a game. So I thought, maybe that's what's going on here. So I try it again. This time, I opened the game and then hit record, and then, sure enough, that worked. But by that point, I didn't want to play the game anymore because I had already played for like about an hour each time, failed both times, and said screw it. So eventually, I came back to it, recorded all that, not to the Ginso tree. I played all the way up to when I was about to enter the Ginso tree, and that was when I stopped for the day. And everything seemed to be working out, so I got to editing the first episode. And first of all, one thing that I noticed while I was recording that first episode, but I didn't address it, didn't say anything, because I was hoping to God it was just the capture and it wouldn't show up in the video itself, was the fact that at the most emotional moment in the opening cinematic, the game froze for a second. Not only did the game freeze, but it also desynced the music, which was like my favorite. Like, that's like one of my favorite moments in gaming, when Ori walks in and there's that piano music, and it just, whole thing was ruined. I was really mad about that, but you know what? I said, you know what? That's fine. I'll fix it in post. And sure enough, I re-recorded the opening section, kind of spliced it in there. Hopefully no one caught that. I don't think anyone has pointed that out yet, that I kind of did some editing there, but I fixed that the best I could. Then, I had the brilliant idea of showing all the different numbers for the skill tree. And at this moment, if you look closely, you might notice actually that I should look this up first, but I think one of the green number 3s flashes briefly, like there was a glitch there. That's just a little sign of what's about to happen, because here's the thing. I didn't know what I was doing when I made this section. I just, in Sony Vegas, just put like 50 different individual text callouts on the screen at once and split the screen down the middle and just put each individual number there on each spot, put each one there individually until it was all done. And by the time that I finished that section, my computer was about to burst into flames because there was so much stuff in this video file. There was like 50 video tracks just because that was the best way I knew how to do it. And so it was barely running it, but when I went frame by frame, it seemed to be working fine. So once I rendered it, I figured it'll be fine. It'll all work out fine. And instead, the finished video turned out like this. Tree, this is what you need to level up for both easy and normal. And this is how many ability points you need for each skill on hard mode. So in addition to the fact that the game is just generally, not really harder, just more tedious. I mean, you do take more damage, but also enemies just have more health. But in addition to that, it takes longer to level up Ori. And also, if you collect all 33 ability cells in the game... So I said, okay, you know what? One thing I left out is that putting in all those text callouts took a little while. Wasn't like a whole day process, but it was a solid like half hour, like a solid 30 minutes of me just sitting there and just putting in this number, putting in that number, putting in that number, and I did not want to do it again. So I just said, you know what? I'm just going to loop these couple seconds. You might notice that if you pay close attention, that at some point the screen kind of jitters, like it skips. That's because I take like a 3-second loop of this video of this screen before it goes to shit, and I just looped those couple seconds over and over again, and then that worked out fine. But then as soon as I close the screen, as soon as I close out of the level up screen, the ability tree, the screen is still getting messed up. So I just put in a black screen saying, "Sorry guys, my capture card took a shit. I'll explain what happened in a later episode." So that's the first episode. Finally got all that shit taken care of. And then I say, "Okay, that's done. I won't need to do that again. Let's go to the next episode." For some reason, the second video file did not save the audio. Just no audio track there. So, yeah, here we go. Now we're finally back to where we were. Gonna redo all of this again. From now on, I am going to... I think Ori can have, like, up to 10 save files, and there is a copy feature. So, yeah, swear to God, I'm gonna have, like, 8 or 9 backup files, because I obviously can't trust this game. Which sucks, because I freaking love this game, and I don't know why it hates me so much. But let's finally get on with the second episode. It's been an ordeal, a freaking ordeal for me to get to episode 2, but let's actually do this. So... we are going into an optional area. This area is not required to beat the game. It's only in the Definitive Edition also. It's not in the original game. Sort of DLC, I guess you could say, more or less, but not quite. I'm not sure if this game had DLC. Look at me just suddenly switching gears from like, oh, just everything sucks. All right, so, and then just next moment. All right, so this section of the game is actually something that's only in this version. Okay, let's just get back into the swing of things. Everything will be fine. I didn't read that out loud because I'm sure you guys can read. So many years ago, the spirit tree was but a sprout. Naru, the young one, looked after us whenever she could. I think that's the first time we've established her name. I think. I don't think the game ever outright tells you who Naru is. It's kind of pieced together. It's that mother figure that was watching over Ori. The one who died in the prologue. That's Naru. And this is apparently her home. So, first optional area of the game. First of two, really. Welcome to Blackroot Burrows. So if you're playing this game for the very first time, this level f***ing sucks. It is if you don't know what you're doing, it's awful. Because you can't see where you're going. You need to just kind of take some guesses here. So generally, try and follow the lights going down here. But again, there's kind of a light area up there as well. So again, luckily, I know this area. I know it very well. So I know what you're doing. I think if you just drop down to the left here, there's spikes down there. So you need to jump over here. Where it's safe. Hang on, I need to confirm. Yep, those are spikes. Those are definitely spikes down there. So I just jump over here. There's a light platform there. Yep, spikes down there as well. So you slide down the wall slowly, jump over here. Run over here. I think that the floor is solid here. I think it's safe. Yes. But again... that's only because I've been through this area many times, and I know that it's safe. Okay, so from... okay, shit. That was dumb. Okay, so... yeah, back to one death again, and again, it was a very stupid death. Again, in one life mode, I've made it farther than this. Alright, so from this point onward, it's not as bad. From here on, it's very straightforward. Follow the platforms. Jump onto this tiny little thing here. I gotta say, I love the little animation. Like, if Ori's, like, actually, like... if he has enough space to move around, he's just in a standard standing animation. But if you're close to a ledge, though... oh, I didn't even know that one. But, like, if you're like... I kind of want to get that one I saw a second ago. Yeah, that one, where he's, like, leaning back on the ledge. So many different animations, also. Sorry, I'm just gushing over all the details in this game. Life of the Spirit Tree was a gift from our kind. It was given to Naru, who stood by our side. So here you go. Walk up to here, and press that to pick up objects. So now you move a lot slower... but the trade-off is that all these light things, when you walk up to them, they go away. And for other light things, the alternate happens. The ones that are invisible normally are visible now. Not that there really were any... You probably didn't even know that there were invisible platforms, because they were kind of invisible. So... I'm in danger. Let me save again. Yeah, by the way, when I played through this game on one life mode, which I've tried several times... for some stupid reason, I always tried to go through this area whenever I played one life mode. Even though the achievements, the trophies that you get for clear one life mode are nothing more than simply just beat the game. So I absolutely did not need to go through this level on any of my one life runs, but I did every single time, and I've failed many of my runs because of this level here, even though I didn't need to. But the trade-off is that I do know this area very well, which is very good, because if you don't know this area, it's awful. If you don't know where you're going, you just need to kind of fumble around in the dark until you just guess correctly, and it kind of sucks. Once we have the lantern, though, it's a bit more straightforward, I think. Because now you can see where you're going somewhat, at least. Light all these lamps one by one, make it over here. And now we have some instant death lasers. These are nice. Very nice, especially for one life mode. Those actually killed me one time. Not nice. Alright. Go back here. I had a feeling I couldn't make a solo link if I'd done it over there, because I was like in the way of like a wall that can go away. Regroup is nice. Yeah, you know what? I'm going to get this. Then I'm going to go with the bottom of the combat tree for a little while, and once I get enough of those done, then I'm gonna just go all in the middle here. That's my game plan right now. Because if you're going to try and 100% this game, which, by the way, I'm not sure if I even mentioned that in the first episode, I will be 100%ing this game. And if you want to do that, it is damn near impossible without maxing out that middle tree. The purple tree is, like, absolutely mandatory to collect everything. Because, unlike a lot of Metroidvanias, it tells you how much is in each area. So I have 13% of everything in this area, 47% in that area, and I've only been to two areas so far. But there's also, yeah, it divides them into areas. And, well, I can't look now, but if you look at the middle tree, though, there are perks that show you where all the ability cells are on the map. I haven't explained we haven't even gotten an ability cell yet, but here's an ability cell! These things! It's a free level up, a free ability point, so very nice. I'm surprised they let me make a save there, because there's a wall there that can potentially be a solid wall. I'm surprised it let me make a save there. Alright, so... Oh, maybe because I was holding the orb, and I'll always respawn with the orb? Maybe. Alright, so we're gonna go down here now. Quick flame. I want quick flame. I want spark flame. Eh, I don't care about that. Don't care for that. Yeah, I think I want to make it all the way over to here. And once I make it here, then I'll be good for a good while. Alright, so that's the game plan for now. Oh yeah, and then the middle tree is like... kind of miscellaneous stuff at first. Spirit Magnet, Map Markers, Life Efficiency, Ultra Spirit Magnet, Energy Efficiency. And then from here on, makes Ability Cells show up on the map, Spirit Efficiency, makes Life Cells show up on the map, makes Energy Cells show up on the map, and allows Ori to see through walls and find hidden areas. Which doesn't sound that handy, since that is, this perk right here, but it also shows you where all the see-through walls are on the map as well. And if you don't have the Sense perk, simply put, it will not show you where everything is, because everything that is hidden behind a wall will still not be on the map until you get that last perk. So yeah, again, if you want 100% this game, you pretty much need to either max out that middle tree, or just be very, very good at searching every nook and cranny and finding everything, which I don't have the patience to do. So we're gonna get that tree maxed out. I'm basically gonna completely ignore the green one, that last one where I got the two perks, and that's it. I'm gonna ignore that for a good chunk of this game, just for the time being. My goal is to get the red tree leveled up quite a bit until I have a decent amount of attack power that then to coast me through the rest of the game, and then after that, max out the purple tree. Hopefully, by the time I get the final power up and I have the whole map open to me, hopefully by that point I'll have the purple branch maxed out. Hopefully, yeah. Oh shoot. I knew I was going to get hit there. I just knew I was going to get hit, but I didn't think it would knock me off. God damn it. I'm tempted to just cut this out. I don't think I've edited it. I can't talk today. I can never talk. I don't know why I'm always surprised by this. The fact that I stutter and stammer everywhere. I always do that. Yeah, just same old. What was I saying? Okay, for a second I was like, God, fell again. But this is actually where I want to be. So this was fine. Alright, last thing we gotta do here, and then the whole level will light up, and everything will not suck anymore. Just gotta be patient, which is a bit... Oh, See, this is one reason why I actually seriously considered streaming at some point, because when Cole streams, it's pretty neat to have an audience there. This is kind of a bit of a weird puzzle here. Not really. Just leave the ball there. Alright, that happens every single time I put the ball down. Every single time I do that, after moving around at a very slow pace for so long, when I suddenly have to put that ball down right there, I always screw up that last jump. It happens every single time I play this level, and I'm not even remotely exaggerating. That happens every single time. It is nice that it goes back to you, though. That's really handy. So we're gonna put this in here. I'm just using vague terms now. Got the ball. Gonna put this. Put it in here. I don't know what any of this stuff is actually called, or if any of it has names or anything, but we did a thing. Now everything is lighting up. That's basically this game. We're gonna go over here, fight this thing, collect that thing. I don't know the details of the story, but we're doing good things. That's what we're doing. We're doing good things. Boy, look, even though our light had grown weak in this haze, it lifted the darkness that held claim of this place. Very good. So, now we're gonna go over here and get another spirit tree. I'm not gonna try that. Was looking for Naru, but she was gone when he came. He was swift like the wind and sprinted with haste, but surrounded by darkness, he lost his way. So when he says that he was quick like the wind and sprinted with haste, what that means is we have a move where we can go fast. Dash! That's it. Press the right bumper in order to dash in the direction you're facing. This move is, outside of a few specific scenarios, kind of useless. But since we just got the move, we're going to be using it a lot here. I almost didn't hit the button again. I think it saves whenever you get an ability tree, though, I think, so probably wouldn't have lost too much progress if I'd got squashed there, but it would just kind of have been annoying, you know? All right, see how the camera kind of pans down there? Pull this lever. And it closes again. So, again, obviously, we just got a new move where you can run fast, so you know what they expect us to do with this. No, don't slide down the wall, Ori. You don't have time for this. No, don't do that either. And no problem. Alright, let me grab that. Is that a level up? That is a level up. Very nice. Save the game. Get that right back again. Gonna stick with this branch for a bit. Save the game again. Because on my one life runs, I died many times from this. But of course, since I've played it so much, I know how to do it now, and that was no problem. But my first couple times doing that, yeah, that boulder, it's instant death, by the way, in case you thought that for some reason, or you could have survived that. And there's that weird bug that I keep getting with this game. Whenever I do something that should get me an achievement, instead it records a game clip. That happens every time I do something that's achievement worthy. It's really weird why it does that. I don't know why. And I'm not sure if all my Xbox One games do that, because quite frankly, I don't play any other games on my Xbox One. It's basically this and Rock Band, which I stopped playing for a while now. So yeah, there's a whole bunch more of this area left now that we've inserted the map stone in the map fragments. Which, yeah, that's what it does, by the way, is reveals the rest of the map. But there's all that area there. Can't go over here. Oops. Alright, so down there is where the rest of this level is. But we can't get down there yet. We should return here later. There's much left unknown. Down below, we may find a place they once called their home. Alright, so with that, we're gonna go back to the spirit well and use the warp option. There's only two available right now. Just this one and the one that I got in the last episode. So, we're going to go back here. And now that we have that new ability, now that we've cleared out, I believe, everything that we can possibly get in Blackroot Burrows. Hang on. Yeah, that's everything. There's a little ball of experience there, but I'm like pretty sure we can't get that yet. Yeah, because there's a switch that we had to stomp, or maybe that opens up the next area. I don't know. All I know is that I don't immediately see how to get there, so figure that out later. Anyways, Blackroot Burrows is done. We're back in the main game, And I'm actually going to call it there. So in the next episode, we're going to go back to the main game. We're done with the optional stuff for quite a while now. Yeah, I don't think we're going to go back there until we learn Stomp. Yeah, Stomp. We need to get to the next area. So for the time being, next time in Ori the Blind Forest, hopefully everything won't go to shits, and we will go back to the main game. And see you guys there.